Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Swiss Dota 2 Championships. My name is Morality Clause and I'm joined today by my co-caster Zach Owen on this fight between Team Wasted Talents against Nemetschli Ernst. How are you doing, once again?
It's going good.
Right then.
And thank God Team Wasted Talents have banned out the Queen of Pain. I'm fed up of casting and seeing that hero in every pub game, competitive game that I ever see, watch or play. I'm done with that hero.
As you can hear, my co-caster is slightly salty.
Slightly is not the word. I am really salty. And I really thank Team Wasted Talents for banning Queen of Pain out. Thank you very much.
Well, anyway,
top that one.
I'm not going to. Let's talk about these picks. Eventual Spirit of Shaker, two versatile supports. There's nothing much to say, really.
Yeah, it's a good point. They can be defensive or aggressive, really.
I mean, Offshaker's usually used as sort of a babysitter, sort of a gank creator. Oh, what do we have here?
They're going full YOLO.
The Fat Man has entered the fray.
He has indeed.
And Aristina's going to be picking up a Phantom Lance as well, so... interesting.
Oh, yes, this is a... Aristina's PL is very strong indeed. Let's see what he can do again.
10 seconds to go. See if he can repeat the
5 seconds.
The same achievements as last week, having just the ability to completely stiff... It was amazing, the fact that his whole team was behind, I believe, and he was just taking the entire enemy team apart last week.
Yeah, he literally just soaked up every bit of farm on the map. Farm with his illusions, doing everything.
Well then.
Yeah, he literally took out every single camp on the map, I swear.
It's going to be interesting. Now, let's talk about the Fat Man again. Pudge is not picked up in pro games, and a lot of people ask themselves why he's such a good pub hero, right? I think you're inclined to agree that pro meta is different from pub meta, right?
Oh yeah.
And second, he's just not as good for the reason that first off it's a skill shot you need to hit with the hook, right?
Yeah.
And the dismember, while being guaranteed lockdown, is channeled once again. If you can take an Enigma and get the same result, really.
Yeah, exactly. I just think it's a hook that's his only really good tool. To be honest, like, Rot is a bit naff, and the Flesh Heap stacks, they come good late game, they get there, but it's only really the hook. It's the just separating a hero from rest of his team and just pick him off. That's all Pudge is for.
I mean, what you really need to do is you need to hit the hook, and that's the in the pubs that's the hard part. In the pros it may not as be as hard, but remember, pros place ward everywhere, so seeing the Pudge come ganking is what will take away his main ability, namely the ability of surprise.
And on the pro scene, you never really see Pudge mid. It's usually a Pudge position 4 or a solo offlane Pudge.
Of course, I mean, his mid role, while being highly praised in pubs, is not so common in pros. I mean, you can give the mid to someone else who can use the levels better.
Yeah, like, you usually put Pudge on the offlane as well, because you can get some farm, he's quite survivable. The move speed is probably the massive reason that Pudge isn't picked much. He's only got 285 move speed, which is really bad. It's like, and low armor.
It's almost a slower CM.
Yeah, that's a good point. Like, Pudge is really slow, and like some heroes that go mid, like Queen of Pain, I think that's 295 move speed.
She has the blink as well, remember?
Yeah, like, most mids are really maneuverable, and Pudge isn't.
Now, here's an interesting pick. There's a Tree and Protector being picked, which is something I haven't seen in quite a while. He's fallen off a bit because he just doesn't bring enough to the table in comparison to other people.
Yeah, like, recently we've seen the meta where it's been, like, quite single pick-off orientated, and Treant's better at the I'm gonna team fight you sort of lineup with the Leech Seed, the Living Armor, and especially his Overgrowth. Barrel Kappa!
Now this is going to be very, very potent if they pull this off. Again, they can have the treant overgrowth. They have the gyrocopter with the cooldown, ogre growth into cooldown into whatever Pudge is going to do into
yeah,
that wave
ogre
of
growth.
Ogre growth until that wave of terror.
Yeah, it's going to be lovely.
Ogre growth. Yes, it's all ogre now.
Ogre now.
Now
gyrocopter just goes full damage. I think.
Probably. I mean, there's no one else really suited to be a carry other than Gyrocopter in this team.
Gets the BKB, then afterwards, like, you've got so much survivability with the Treant and the Vengeful Spirit, just go full damage after BKB.
Now let's talk about TWT. They picked up a hero that also hasn't been seen often. It's the Darkseer. I really like watching Darkseer.
Darkseer is also really strong with PL because of that Phantom Rush.
Oh yeah,
and
got to go fast.
Yeah, I want to go fast. And the Spirit Lance as well just slows him down, so more Orange Shout damage.
The Vacuum as well, making can make or break team fights. Vacuum into walls are just it's just that combo, you know.
And the Echo Slam.
Oh yeah, the Vacuum into Echoes. That's this is going to be a very good combo. It's going to be Vacuum into Fissure into Echo Slam into Ice Blast into Wall into whatever PL's going to do.
That's the dream.
What if it's going to happen? That's another story. But you know, it's the dream.
Echo Magnus mid would be pretty good for the Radiant team. Magnus.
Yeah, they have an offlane. They have the carry. They have the two supports. All they need is an offlane. So.
Yeah, because no doubt the Dragon Copter will be going BKB, and Reverse Polarity does go through BKB. Just also a pretty solid stun, I'd say, the Reverse Polarity. And you can also skewer back Pudge, he's not very maneuverable. I think you can skewer out of Overgrowth, am I right?
Yes, I believe so. Overgrowth is Entangle, not a stun.
Yeah, and with the Vengeful Spirit, if you get swapped out, you just skewer right away. Just depends if Forced is quite confident on that. Maybe Puck still. Puck's still pretty good here.
Yeah, counter initiation. They pick up an Ember Spirit who I have not seen in ages.
That's a mid Ember there.
Most likely. Pudge is probably going to be going on the offlane then.
Yeah, the main reason they're picking up the Ember here is because of the Phantom Lancer illusions and the Darkseer illusions. Just think of the cleave.
Slate of Fist is a good idea there. They're going to need the Battle Furies though.
Battle Furies.
Furies, two of them, at least.
He's gonna have his stash filled out with Battle Furies.
It's like, I'm gonna do more damage to everyone around you than you, the guy I'm actually supposed to be attacking.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's like if you get Battle Furies on Sven, I believe. That's what happens. Your cleave starts doing more damage to everyone apart from the one you're attacking.
Yeah, 65% on Sven, plus Battle Furies 100%, so. And then get any more than that, and it just goes really bad for the enemy team.
So TWT have to pick something that's a lane against the Ember Spirits. There's actually a lot that can be lane against the Ember Spirit. Remember, he is only a melee.
Yeah, Magnus, and I called it.
Good job there. it's a very good pick. It can. Both of these teams have very good team fight, to be honest.
Oh, I can't wait to see the Wombo combo.
I'm gonna say TWT has the better team fight though.
Oh yeah. Indeed. Like, I'm just so happy about how I predicted the Magnus.
You're elated.
Yeah, I am.
Right, so
I'll have the Radiant again, is that okay?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Okay, we have El Liberator playing the Darkseer. We have Haki playing an Ancient Apparition. He's showing some versatility. We have Forced playing the Magnus. And is he rocking any cosmetics? No, he's not. Erastina going to the bot lane.
He does have a horn. Magnus does have a horn.
He has a horn. Okay, and Erastina rocking the PL. And we have Noel playing the Earthshaker.
No, I mean he has a horn cosmetic, that was what I was trying to say.
I know he has the horn cosmetic, yeah, I just see.
Alright then.
He has the taunt as well.
I will be presenting NCE then on the Ember Spirit. We have Original Blunt on the Eventual Spirit. We have Speaker for Ender. We have Hagelicious playing Gyrocopter. Intergraphic will be playing Pudge. Intergraphic did play mid, so maybe a mid Pudge, and we're going to see an offlane Ember. Doesn't sound very good, but you know, it could be. And last but not least, we have Bigoudi Tina playing Treant Protector.
Oh, El Liberator, he's living life on the edge.
He can never got to go fast though if he absolutely wants to get away.
Yeah, with the spikes on his back and the surge, he's definitely a...
I'm just trying to find out. NTE have one secure stun. Like, good one stun actually. that doesn't require any setup. Or
yeah,
any...
like the Hovind missile.
Which requires, like, you know, which can be destroyed. So it's not really a secure stun.
You have that Ember Spirit, Searing Chains. Searing Chains, maybe that could help.
It's only an Entangle, though.
Yeah, that's a great point.
Forced has taken in power level 1. I didn't want to talk about that.
My friend Jaskaran does it quite a lot. It just boosts, it gives 11 extra bonus damage, it gives 10 bonus damage without any stats or anything. So it just gives Magnus just the upper edge and that little bit of harass as well. And it's only 20%.
Ooh, Forced.
It's only 20% cleave anyway, so it doesn't really push the lane too far at all.
Point then. It's an interesting, usually you take Shockwave first or the Skibber first if you really want to. Skewer if you want to do some nasty, put people on cliff tricks, and Shockwave if you are want the lane to be kind of unopposed.
No, in power first, that's totally acceptable. And if you have a look at Force base damage compared to original Blunts, that's fine.
Yeah, 61 versus 57 is pretty good, and now add on the 12, it's like 70.
Yeah, exactly, it's really good. Right. Agnes is my bae too.
Now, of course, the chat has been saying something, like one of the guys has been saying something, is the fact that they picked a PL and did not ban the Ember.
Yeah, that's a great point there.
It's Ember is like the quintessential counter to PL. Now, Eldebrator could be in a bit of trouble here. But he has got to go faster, he should be able to get away.
Yeah, they're not going to pursue any further. And we've sort of missed the Wave of Terror plus Treant punches. Wow. Like, the Minus Armor, just...
That is a good point, although, remember, Liberator, the Darkseid is famous for just being able to stay alive and be able to farm long range.
Yeah, especially and the Gyrocopter has that homing missile level, so that should be good.
It's interesting, it's like he's going for a more stun-orientated build.
Yeah. Probably the best way to lock down Darkseid, he's really quick.
Good point. Thing is though, like you said, he's really quick, he can just run away from the homing missile.
Well, with the magic missile on top, I don't think he's going anywhere. We'll see what happens, they have to execute it perfectly to kill El Liberator, playing really carefully.
Thing is though, he already finished off his soul ring, so he can just start spamming out iron shells whenever he wants. He doesn't really have to, go in deep.
Yeah, he's got more than the Pudge right now.
Oh yeah, good point. Forgot to bring up the last hits, in fact.
yeah, that's a good thing about Darkseer is he can find farm, but the only problem is that he can't really deny it.
That's...
Like, the best offlaners in the whole entire game are ones that can deny it. Like Clockwork, for example, he cogs and then... Yeah, they can't get the creeps fast enough. It's under your tower, they can't CS, and yeah, the best offlaners are the ones that can deny a farm.
Ooh, Magnus and 4. Magnus and Original Blunt are fighting it out a bit. Trading last hits.
Yeah, big brawl on the mid lane.
And you know, Liberator is getting zoned, but he doesn't care. Remember, he has Iron Shell. He can long range if he really wants to. Oh, into Graphic. Looks like to be in a bit of trouble. Ooh, nice going there. Being able to get the cold feet off. And of course, Chilling Touch.
Chilling Touch. Strongest level 1 ability. Well, for your team, of course.
And this is a tri-lane, so there, he managed to get Chilling Touch on all three. It's pretty good.
Yeah, how much bonus damage is it? Is it 40? 30?
Level 1, it's... I think
level
it's 30.
50 level 1.
60, actually. 60 level 2. They had it on level 2. And a smoke gank coming in from Lolian Hacky.
Yeah, they have cold feet plus Fissure as well, so that's pretty much guaranteed lock.
And the Magnus is there. If he really wants to, he can Skewer. In fact, that's what he's gonna... Oh no, he's actually gonna use RP here and Skewer right back in. Cold feet will not hit though, and Force might look like he's in a bit of trouble. That gank failed.
Yeah, miscommunication. They definitely stacked the stuns then.
Yeah.
Like, I didn't think the reverse polarity was necessary.
Like, I think just the skewer back,
and
yeah.
Then they should have skewered then RP.
Just to make sure the cold feet is definitely there.
Yeah, that was really, really unfortunate because they did have a good idea to go there.
Meanwhile, El Liberator is doing pretty well for himself because most of the lane, because Ventral had to rotate boss, he's now level 4 compared to Pudge's level 3.
Oh, we got a lol. What's happened?
I'm not sure, actually.
No, none of us know. Earthshaker getting the me time on the mid lane, getting some levels, but original Blunt could probably make a go if he had 4 mana.
Which he doesn't, unfortunately. He does have quite a bit, but it's not enough to kill the Earthshaker, especially now that Magnus has come in with a level 3 Shockwave. So Magnus has, in fact, transitioned over to the standard build, instead opting to go for Skewer first. To go for Empower first. Yeah.
Best way to get his new damage out.
And now Noli is going to contest this rune bot. Oh, original Blunt actually manages to pick it up. Will he Fissure is the question. No, he will not. Darkseer, meanwhile, is too far away to be of use. There you go. Pudge, in fact, killing Ancient Apparition on the bot lane as they go in on him. Missed that as I was watching this engagement top.
Yeah, he got the hook, and he rotted down.
Liberator! Could be in a bit of trouble here.
Oh, their RP's up in 5 seconds, see if they're going to make a turn.
Are they? Noli is there. Noli is there.
I reckon they should have went on that. I reckon they could have killed them all.
They could have.
Just the Venge and the Treant, they could have killed them.
They could have tapped it, yeah.
Force has to time the last hits with the Iron Shell now.
Unfortunate, that was not a very good decision, El Liberator. But, you know, maybe he was expecting Force to do something else. Net worth is 2,000 for TDB2, so recoverable without any...
Yeah, nowhere near non-consensual yet.
It's not even bad yet. And, yep, Ember's going the phase boost build, so he's definitely going for a bit more damage.
Yeah, Pudge just committed suicide on the bot lane.
Aristina once again, proving his worth. He's going the good old, he's going Morbid Mask. You think he's going to get a Mask of Madness again?
I think it might be just the casual Morbid Mask. He might go back for a Midas or the Power Shred.
Got 1,000 gold saved up. It's going to be interesting what he's going to get here.
Quilla.
Nope, yep, he's getting a Blade of Alacrity, so it's probably going to be a Diffusal next.
Yeah, quick Diffusal Blade would be really good against a Gyrocopter.
Actually, it could also be a Casual Yasha. We did see that a lot.
Oh, Casual Yasha is the best Yasha. Oh, and more wards coming out on the side of the Dire, where the Radiant have none.
That's actually interesting. If we look at the vision map, that is true. There are no wards on the side of the Radiant.
Legally planned.
That is interesting. Usually, you'd see a few more wards. Pudge and Vengeful are actually going to start going for ganks here.
Yeah, I think they can. They've got massive.
Ooh! Like I said, they missed that hook. If you miss it, it's not too good.
You can only really throw out one hook and he's out of mana.
That's another problem with Pudge, and Force will in fact start skewering the Pudge back. They're trying to get him, but he's a Magnus, he's mobile. Oh, Darkseid actually getting a kill on the Gyro. Gyro getting a return kill on the PL. Missed that engagement.
Yeah, I wasn't watching either. I was looking at the bot lane.
We look at the fight recap quickly. It's just Gyro throwing out all his abilities. PL, probably all used on the PL.
Okay, can I just ask, when is the next series after this?
I'm expecting 3. Depends on if the teams are there or not.
2 o'clock my time.
2 o'clock your time, yeah.
Okay, thank you. Dire's top tower's getting beat down. Okay, Team Wasted Talent's looking very strong at the moment with 2, with PL and Magnus quite high up on the CS, but Gyrocopter is towering over them all.
Of course, I mean, he has Flag Cannon. That's all you can really say to that.
Yeah, 1v1 me, flak.
But remember,
they have,
like...
Go, you go.
No, you say whatever you want to say.
Alright, so they have masses of ways to deal with these PL illusions, with the flat cannon, definitely the Ember Spirit as well.
Ooh, Haggilicious. Dodges the cooldown, nice, and he's actually going to go right in on Speaker Friender here. Will he be able to get Speaker Friender? No, they have Rocket Barrage on available. In fact, now they've got the creep blocks for the tower, though, so Haggilicious will fall. Aristida doesn't have anything in terms of escape, though, so there's nothing he can do. Next one to fall will probably be Elebrator. That's a 2-for-1.
Great reaction times there. Great communication.
Oh, that hook. You could have dodged that forced. In fact, or maybe he was expecting it, taking into graphic back with him.
Have you seen forced items? Casual mango?
Well, the mango is always good. Especially the later you use the mango, the more valuable it is, remember?
Oh, yeah, of course. Oh, we just ate the mango.
Well then. Net worth. Aristina's leading, but Original Blunt is actually looking close. In fact, Original Blunt just overtook Aristina. Magnus following. The Gyrocopter isn't actually so high up as I expected him to be.
But we're also single position on the top lane.
Gyrocopter now, but into graphic, will he take a fall for that? He probably will. PL. Oh no, he suicides! Good suicide there. It's not what you usually want to say. Good suicide.
Good suicide. Quite a shady topic, Dota, isn't it?
Yes. Quite a dark place.
Never come out of the dark place. Dota just...
Doc's here. Doc's here is actually about to finish off his mech.
Yep, Beck's really good on Darkseer in my opinion, he has a really high mana pool.
There's a lot of reactions. That's a lot of TPs. Does Intergraphic have? Yes, he has Dismember just used, but remember Aristina has Doppelganger, which he will use right now. He's going to have to run. Nice hook by Intergraphic. But actually, that's going to kill Intergraphic. No, Intergraphic suicides. Good reactions there. And PL will die. Intergraphic in his suicide. Jesus.
Like, how many towers have gone down so far? There's no towers going down, and to be fair, the Radiant have a really good push lineup between the Magnus Cleave, the PL, and the Darkseer. Like, I'm surprised they haven't taken any objectives yet.
No, that's really is surprising. But the thing is that the Raya have a good counter push. They have the Flat Cannon, they have the Ember Slater Fists, they have Wave of Terror. They can counter push air all day, any day.
I reckon casual Yasha on that Ember Spirit and then straight into some Battle Furies, I think.
He's going an early fighting build, so it's interesting. The drums suggest early fighting, which means... Oh, where's the RP? Direct on Haggilicious. The hook is not there. Haggilicious will die, meaning he's not available for this fight. Good Echo Slam on Speaker Friender, but that's the only one left. That's the only one he got there. PL, will he get the kill here? Speaker Friender does manage to get off a nice hook onto Speaker Friender. Oh! The damage on the Chilling Touch almost got him. Oh, Haki! Haki looks like he's in a bit of trouble. Nori too, but there's the freezing field, and Haki will die. Forced is chasing now. Original Blunt needs to run, but he will not be able to get away.
Everyone's so low.
Ancient Apparition could have a field day. Ice Blast, not freezing field. I am sorry.
Top lane, El Liberator, he's going in deep.
Iron Shell, very good skill here, and it looks like he might actually find Big Goody Tina.
Oh, Dota 2 headshot, nah, maybe not.
Whoa, that was a good escape from Tina.
Yeah, he timed that just right.
A bit long, and it would have been a pretty dead tree in there.
Save the trees, don't kill them.
Aristina looks like he wants to get Haggilicious, but Flat Cannon is now off on cooldown, so he could go in there with some help.
What I really like from the Dire team is, Haggilicious was playing the solo offlane Centaur, now he's playing the safe lane Gyrocopter.
Now rotating really around rolls a bit, yeah.
Yeah, it shows they're quite confident within themselves.
Now a Hotted has been finished on the Gyro, so he's going a standard Gyro build there. Except the Phase Boots, Phase Boots are standard on Gyro. Speaking of someone else, phase into the Hotted into damage items.
Yeah, BKB, MKB is probably the most popular build with a butterfly somewhere in there. Then four rapiers.
Four rapiers if you really want to go late. Ooh, RP's up. RP is up. Will he use RP for the solo target? Ancient Apparition meanwhile getting a kill top on the Vengeful Spirit. Ice Blast onto two. Nice reactions there. Overgrowth is popped, but will it be enough? Can they kill them with the Ice Blast? No, they will not be able to kill into Graphic, but they will be able to kill Treant. In fact, Elderbrotor gets a double kill. And now let's turn to the original Blunt, who dies to Forced.
Wow.
Losing play. Four. Losing three. Losing four. No, four. Losing four.
Yeah, four across the map, yeah. It's space created for the Gyrocopter, but I don't think it's worth it.
Very good. Very good. So, now we should be starting to... Now, I mean, they took one tower now. That's the first tower of the game.
Yeah, have you seen this Radiant coverage?
Let me see. Like, they've gone from no wards at all to, like, lots of defensive wards. Some aggressive, like, up there. There's one there. And there's one there.
Oh, yeah, I see what you're on about.
But mostly this one here is just a defensive ward right there. Into Graphic waiting for his chance. He doesn't have too much. He has Tranks and a... He's level 6?
Hasn't got much at all, and he's got less. Yeah, he's got less net worth than the Vengeful Spirit. There we go.
I'm looking at the hero levels. This is not good for Dire. Not good at all for Dire. With PL now leading in net worth, pretty far ahead from the Gyro actually. 1,000, and he's actually going to find the Gyro. Will Gyro be able to do much? No flat cannon. He's actually going to call down. Aristide doesn't have the mana to dodge, but he doesn't care. He's just staying right there. Oh, but the potted is doing work.
The living armor was also helping out a lot there.
Yeah.
And you did predict the casual Yasha on Aristina.
And he did go it last time. It's a good damage item. It delays the defusal, but it's good for damage. Whoa! Did you see that vacuum? Managing to dodge the hook, managing to make Into Graphic just miss the hook slightly. Oh, there's the wall popped. No vacuum there. Pretty bad wall.
Whoa.
What was that RP?
I think the blink was on cooldown.
Pink was accidental blink there, I'm gonna say.
Oh no, the Vengeful Spirit poked him once. Before he
blinked.
That was a misplay, but nevertheless, there's still two kills in the mid tower going on.
Yeah. Interesting, it's like this wall there isn't gonna do much, and the RP was there instead of there where he wanted it to be. So, not very good. Meanwhile, Original Blunt is trying to split push, having to resort
right,
to...
Nah, he's not gonna do him back. Alright, 1 second, I just need this.
Now, around now... Now, which team do you think is better in the mid-game? But, which is around now?
Definitely Wasted Talents here.
And that's unfortunate, because Wasted Talents also has a really good late-game lineup.
Yeah, maybe the Ember Spirit and the Gyrocopter with their mid-game physical magic damage could bring it back for them, but Pudge is just too underleveled. On equal terms in farm, I would really back the Dire side.
But right now, it's like the Treant is level 7. The Pudge is level 7. He's got nothing.
Yeah.
Treant has an urn, and that's really it, and the Gyro is the only one really with items, but even his items pale in comparison to Iristina's items.
Oh, he's getting that Defusal Blade up and up soon.
And that means he's just going to do so much more damage. Smokes up from Radiant. But they will not find anything, as TWT, the NCE, back off.
I think they've just relegated this Pudge now to a sort of support role. He's not really doing much.
That is good, that is true.
But it's level 7, but I don't think he's going to get much else done here.
A good thing to note is that net worth is now 10,000, leading up to 12,000.
Yeah, I think so.
So it's like, oh, what is Original Blunt doing? Not a good idea there, but he gets out, so it's okay. Living armor, keeping the tower alive for a bit longer. But that's a lost tower. Slate of Fists, just doing a bit of poke damage.
Yeah, that's another tower going down as well. At least the glyph's back up.
Original Blunt, they're getting engaged upon. There he goes.
Original Blunt. I still can't get over his name.
There's so many good names coming out of this tournament.
Yeah, snowboarding is the best so far. Davey's pretty, quite English pub term there. Erisino, I don't know what that translates as. Maybe it's just a fancy name.
House is pretty good. I mean, oh, Pudge, that hook. I think this is the problem with Pudge right now. He's hooking, but never mind. Gyro initiates, what a vacuum, but it doesn't do anything. Kavak, it's going to cost Alibrator his life. Aristina, meanwhile, killing the train off first. And now the RP was baited, but was not used.
Ooh.
Hook onto the forced. It looks like this might actually kill him. No! There is help from his own team. Leading to a nice double kill for Aristina.
Yeah. Well played there. There's a big Echo Slam as well.
1,000 gold swing. It's 1,400 XP.
Blink Dagger on Earthshaker, I didn't see that one.
Oh yeah, that's a pretty quick Blink Dagger for a support Earthshaker.
Yeah.
And Ember Spirit is building up towards his first Battle Fury.
Yep, and that should be the turnaround item in my opinion.
Problem is, Aristina is so farmed right now.
Yeah, I reckon he'll get a Skadi soon, or maybe a Sanjin Yasha.
Oh, there you go. Nice hook by Intergraphic. Haki will fall. And now Aristina needs to get out of there, because he's got a lot of people. Overgrowth misses. Not a good time to overgrowth.
Yeah, that wasn't timed quite correctly, was it?
No, not really.
Yeah.
In fact, the Liberator has a Blink Dagger. It's a pretty good item in Darkseid that I just don't see often enough.
Yeah, it's a really good point there.
I mean, it gives him so much mobility. It lets him put a precise vacuum walls.
Yeah.
Look at the net worth as well. 14,000 for TWT. It's plateauing, yeah. But nothing much to do there.
Yeah.
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 You know, your Ember Spirit is actually skipping creeps here. There he goes.
Yeah, that's probably the best way to stop the pushes coming in. Like, that's what I sort of do when I need to come back.
But, you know, Aristina being Aristina, he's just going to start pushing right here.
Yeah. He doesn't give a crap, to be honest. He's just going to walk up to their tier 3s right now.
Well, I hope not, because he's probably going to end up very dead.
Yeah.
His smoke's up from Radiant. Gonna wrap around like this, most likely. Actually, no, they're going to take the alternate path up here. Oh, they're gonna find Intergraphic, who gets a hook, but it's unfortunately not worth it there.
Right. Yeah, we haven't seen the Wombo combo yet, have we?
Oh, you mean the vacuum into Fissure into Wall into Echo?
The reverse polarity and all that sort of stuff.
There you go. Look at this. Aristide's going ham on Ender. In fact, there's a nice Fissure block just securing his fate.
That's another death.
Sealing his fate. And this tower will fall. Most likely.
So, Roshan potential. What do you think on the side of the Radiant? Do you reckon they can just walk in there and take it?
They don't have too much armor reduction, as I believe. I feel like they can't just walk in, but they have the Empower, so they technically could.
Yeah, they really should think about getting the Roshan before they go any further.
I'm just going to have a look at the ward coverage from Dire quickly, and it is pretty good around the runes, but there's nothing in their jungle, like up here. There's nothing by Roshan, like, where's the raw ward position by Roshan? Yeah, right there. So, no actual, you know, it's only rune wards right now, and it's a good Rosh ward here and here, but...
Oh! That's really weird. I didn't know I could see your camera angle on the map as well.
You didn't?
No, I didn't. Oh, you could see mine too, right?
Yes.
Oh, there we go.
That's pretty good. It's a pretty good trick.
Yeah, I didn't know that. It was quite, I can't really see it on my screen, but...
Invis Force Blunt is gonna just gonna be kept there. I just gotta stunlock him. Say no to mobility there.
Only one word to describe that. Wrecked.
And El Liberator has actually finished off Guardian's Greaves. That's a lot of sustain on the side of TWT.
That was a... Okay, your animation cancelled his hook then. I was wondering what he was doing then.
Aristine is just like, right in front of Hagalicious, like, I'm just gonna keep farming up right in front of your face. In fact, I'm gonna steal some of your mana while you're at it.
Yeah, forced to give Noel some cleave as well, so he's maxing Enchantotem right now. Maxed it over Aftershock and Fisheries, the Enchantotem.
Well, I mean, it's good damage.
Yeah, he hits for a rapier when he's got the buff on.
Definitely Kate gets rid of the supports. Oh, and the cleave, of course.
Yeah, the cleave.
Yeah, you mentioned that.
Oh, come on, you haven't done mid-earth shaker, have you?
I really haven't. My team doesn't let me do crit shaker.
Oh, crit shaker's the best. Just get four battle furies, Daedalus, it's just fun as hell.
It's like, I want to do that now. I really want to do that now.
Yeah.
If only pubs weren't so toxic. Oh well.
Yeah, that's the problem.
Here we go. BKB's about to come up on Gyro, so you think we're going to see a small swing in the side of Dire when that wants to get their BKB's?
Yeah, I think so. Mainly, like, all of their damage right now, apart from Aristina, is mainly magical damage, so Gyrocopter should be able to get all the flat cannon off. And with that Vengeful Spirit aura as well.
Ember walking up here, noticing the entire enemy team was looking around there, and it's like, nope, I'm out. Pudge's hooks have been on point when he's going for the Ancient Apparition, but otherwise not really that great.
Yeah, he can only really hook Haki at the moment.
And yes, the Battle Furies are up on Ember Spirit, so they've got a good counter against the PL now. Smoke's up.
Yes, let's see if they can get something done with the smoke now. Oh, they've left little tree ants out. He hasn't had a little, you know, he hasn't had a little stuck on the blunt, but unfortunate for him.
Oh, once again, Rosh. This could be a repeat of the Rosh fight we had last time. But now they've revealed themselves and everyone's backing off.
Yeah, everyone's get the fuck out. Here we go, they're going
ooh,
in.
Oh, hook miss, nice RP! Oh, what an Echo Slam! Oh, everyone's dying!
One more combo!
Magnus actually ends up dead thanks to Searing Chains.
That was very well played indeed, and Ember Spirit just got 1,000 gold from killing off the Magnus then. I still think it's a Roshan anyway.
Yeah. It's 1,000 gold swing actually for DWT there.
Yeah, the RP was at a 3-man RP with the wall on the top.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was really well played by them. They really didn't cancel the Blink of the Magnus, which I thought they would have with the Wave of Terror or with the cooldown. They really left Magnus open to get that really big RP off there.
Yeah. I mean, stunning Noli was a good idea, but you should have gotten rid of the Magnus as an issue first.
I think a Zeus would have been really strong for the side of the Dire, just to cancel the Blink Daggers and stuff, but, you know, yeah. They prioritised the Treant and the Ember over that. Like, to support Zeus would have just been perfect. Like, you know, high nuke damage against AA and the Earthshaker, and also really good against PL Illusions, but...
What is original Blunt is diving deep, but nope, there he goes. Yes, you have got a point there. The Zeus would have been really good.
So, in your opinion, you know Phantom Rush, most players don't get more than one level in it. Like, are you a player to get more than one level in it?
One level in Phantom Rush? Not really. I mean, the stats are just better. Just better. I mean, maybe get to level 2, but that's really it, really.
I think Phantom Rush should be like a toggled ability.
Yeah.
Like, you can put it on auto cast, for example, and stuff like that. Because otherwise, you just dive in deep and you don't want to go in deep. Like, you're sprinting after someone on. It's not. Oh, here we go on.
The Goonie Tina is going to end up dead here.
That's unfortunate.
These two wards are actually going to deward. They have a gem on the Earthshaker.
I'm going to punch some wards. Oh, BKB on Gyrocopter. It's very late though. It's 30 minutes in, but he still has 1,000 gold on top. And Erisine is just going to punch the man with the illusions. He's just going to punch the tier 3s.
There you go. Oh. Well, their original blunt doing a lot of damage with Slate of Fist, but like I said, they're just going to do the tier 3. Aristina not getting hooked there.
Yeah, he knew what's up.
In fact, he's got Aegis, so he doesn't care. And there's Hagalicious. It's going to end up the first casualty. No, good save. He's got Aegis, remember? Oh, there goes Speakfriender. Hooks are in, but Intergraphic does not get anyone. And that's already two people down. One of them being one of their main cores, one of the people they relied on to kill the PL. Oh, these hooks from Intergraphic are doing well, but it's not the best. And here's Gyro, here's El Liberator. Will he vacuum? He already has vacuum. Wall is up, probably just the zoning wall while Aristina tries and gets this tier 3. I think this is it, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, I think that's definitely one or two racks going down.
Original Blunt's in, but he's into the wall. And he has to retreat immediately. Overgrowth is there, but there's no one there to use it. Bigoditina will be the next one to fall. And godlike on Aristina.
And Aristina's using his illusions.
Now everyone's a bit low, so once later Fist could do some work here, but now... Ooh, there you go, Guardian's Greaves. That's a dead speaker friend. It's an Ags Ice Blast. He's dead.
Oh, that's very sad. That's always like the worst part, isn't it? When you get hit by an AA Ice Blast and you know you're gonna tick out and you just have to wait those few seconds.
You know, Gyrocopter just used a 10-second BKB for no apparent reason.
Was he in base?
Yeah, he was full health.
Premature BKB, that's what I like to call that.
I don't know what that was for.
I think it might have been a misclick.
Yeah, probably. Well, nobody saw that apart from us.
Yep, won't say anything. And Magnus has his own BKB.
Oh, that's not good. That's not good.
Yep. Gonna walk in there and kill everything.
That is not good at all. Aristina, meanwhile, has the BOTs. He's got 5,000 gold saved up. He's got his Manta. What do you think he's going to get? Scythe or Heart? Or Butterfly?
Scythe. Yeah. Scythe gives more damage and health for an hero, so Scythe would be better.
Most likely, yeah. Especially considering he's got the cleave. Damage could really come in useful. Although...
Especially if he's slow as well.
I'm thinking a Heart would be good here as well, due to the fact that the health versus the Ember. Good hook on Haki, making sure he won't have Ice Blast for this fight. Actually, no, he gets saved! And that means this is going to be a dead Tina first. Hagalicious gets a lot on the cooldown, but it's not enough, and he will end up dead. He buys back, though. They want to take this fight again. And now Aristina's on the back lines. Aegis, he still has Aegis. Nice save by Intergraphic, but Hagalicious dies. And that means he's going to be on the long cooldown. And now they're just going to casually take Rex.
I think the problem here was is Gyrocopter didn't find enough farm.
Ooh, Aristina! Aegis will be popped, but you know what? That's what Aegis is there for. Original Blunt will fall. And so will the ranged Rax. Melee Rax. Melee Rax, and now there you go. The base camp has begun.
Yep, here we go. Pub Dota.
Ooh, El Liberator actually ends up dead here. To be honest, I would just go for the second set of racks here. Secure the win.
Yeah, secure the win. They're just like they have the Pudge as well. Pudge can always hook them into the fountain.
There's actually crit stick up on Ember, so he's doing a lot of damage, but is it enough to clear out the illusions?
Yeah, he's definitely clearing out. Oh, he's purchased the butterfly because of the Ember Spirit right clicks.
That's actually a pretty good idea, yeah. Get the butterfly first, which forces Ember to buy an MKB.
Yeah, definitely.
There you go, and he's backing off. Let's check the net worth graph. It's 30,000 rising up to 40,000. XP is 20,000 rising up to 30,000. Actually declining. No level caps hit yet, I believe. If we check the hero levels. Yep, no level caps hit yet, so...
Yeah, I think the dire side should start tapping out. When the AA has more farm than the Gyrocopter.
Oh, that's not good. And the Ember Spirit is only up on 4th. Aristina's just so farmed right now.
Yeah, indeed. He's snowballing out of control, and he's just played amazing on this PL. What do you think he goes to complete the build? Do you think it's a Vladimir's offering?
You know, he could just... I think he needs really... That's the thing. He needs some health items, doesn't he?
Yeah, he definitely does. He's only got 1700. Microphone muted. And, yeah, he's got the Magnus Cleave. There's a RP on the top lane, and Aristina just walks up there, and the Skewer finishes him off.
Good work there.
Yeah, and Skewer damage is really underrated.
Oh, yeah, it's 280 what damage. It's 280 damage. It's magical, which means it gets you resisted, but it's still 280. It's basically a nuke there.
Basically a shockwave.
Another shockwave to Avon. People don't think Skewer does that much damage, but it's pretty good. And there's a Fisher. They see Tina thanks to the gem. And this means they should start pushing up.
Aristina's like already got the memo. He's up there. He's just going ham on this. Oh, my infantry out.
That's not going to help, though. Even we saw how much Overgrowth did in these fights.
Intergraphic taking a Spirit Lance in the Gabba.
Oh, there's Ice Plaf. Oh. That's a dead Intergraphic.
Oh, play the Titanic music.
Second set of racks are now about to fall, whereas Aristina is just going ham on the back line.
Alright, here we go. Past non-consensual.
Now about when the entire enemy team is just dying.
Yeah, it's non-consensual. They have 3 times more kills.
Alright, last set of racks are about to fall.
Here we go. I don't want to say it, but I think it's GG, 36 minutes in. Well played by Wasted Talents. They're just flexing up the racks right now.
NCE will fall. I mean, NCE did not draft badly. Maybe the Pudge could have been replaced by something a bit more useful.
Yeah, even that solo offlane Zeus could have been pretty good.
I mean, I'm looking at it. Wasn't it a last pick Earthshaker?
It was a first pick Earthshaker.
Oh, yeah, it was. I don't know if players, right? So, yeah, it was a first pick Earthshaker, so unfortunately, not there. But, yeah, like you said, it's Zeus. But Aristina doesn't care.
Yeah, he doesn't care. He's got that
one. Oh, my God. Aristina, stop.
They just keep hitting him.
He just keeps going and going and going.
I think we see a rampage. Oh no, he's getting focused by the Phantom now.
In fact, he got an ultra kill.
Ultra kill.
Oh, come on. Just take the roll. Just take the throne, guys.
Yeah, come on.
You've been non-consensual enough here.
Yeah, the GPM on Aristina is 675 as well. That's really good.
682.
682, the tower's going down as well.
Throne will now fall.
Haki's just walking up to the Treant.
DG, thanks for the gem. Some shit talk going on here.
Yeah, indeed.
Anyway, there we go. GG, well played. NCA, unfortunately, are now out of the tournament. Well played to them.
Yeah.
Now Team Wasted Talent will continue on to the secondary preliminary finals for the chance to play against My Insanity. In the offline finals. Last week did pretty
crushed.
Well. Yeah, crushed.
Crushed, to be quite honest with you. 9-minute GGs.
It was pretty good.
Pretty good.
Yeah, well then, anyway, we will be back later for game 2, which will be Rhino Gaming versus... I'm not sure right now. Hang on, let me check.
Oh, it's that really long word that I can't...
Oh yeah, Hornig Menders, right. Hornig
there
Menders.
There we go.
Rhino Gaming versus Hornig Menders. Until then, see ya.
See you later.